Hey everybody, welcome to Infinite Realms, and today we're going to review Marvel Legends Captain Britain. Now, it's really kind of funny because anytime I run into Captain Britain now, I get a memory flashback. Back in the day, we used to rather write these things and take static pictures. I did some of that, and I did a review of the Captain America 3-pack. Oh, I'm trying to remember the name of it, and I can't. But, anyway, it hit Captain Britain, Red Guardian, and Captain America. So, you know, this is after I'd given three other Captain Britons a really good review, too. Keep that in mind. And, you know, I said, well, this Captain Britain kind of sucks, you know. And I do believe that still to this day. And anyway, the comment section went nuts saying the reason I didn't like Captain Britain, even though I clearly said I liked Captain Britain, and even though I'd given three favorable reviews to three other Captain Britain figures, but they said the reason I didn't like Captain Britain was because I was raised in America and raised with Captain America. And that's when I figured out people don't read. They really don't. I mean, I don't know. But here we are with Captain Britain, and you know, that's got me thinking maybe I'll dig up some of those old reviews and read off the review and just, you know, use the static shots. I don't know. We'll see. But, you know, Brian Braddock, y'all. And yeah, this is not exactly the classic Captain Britain, but it is pretty good. I do like it. I mean, it's very colorful, very nice, and you know, looks very comic accurate. I did look up some source pictures, and yeah, this looks pretty great. I do like, you know, the two-tone blues here on the arms. And the reds really pop, and the whites really pop. And I like that they kind of went, you know, kind of did some things that go out of the, go away from the Union Jack, British flag. I think that's kind of cool too. I like the black around the eyes. I just think that's more striking than just plain white eyes. That's really, I really like that too. He's a big beefy figure, that's for dang sure. And of course, he looks really good flying. I noticed I put him in flying poses, and I thought he looked really, really darn great in those poses. Now, as I said, he is a big beefy character, and that suits Captain Britain. I think he should be a big beefy figure. I think it's nice. I like the symbols on the side. Really nice, the golden lion on each side. That just really brings a really nice touch to the figure. Articulation is pretty standard as always. I mean, it's Marvel Legends, guys. I mean, we all know what they do. They have, of course, it's an older one, so it has pins, but that's okay. Everywhere there's pins, it's the same color on both sides, so it's not a huge deal. That I can handle. I always say I don't mind that part. It's when there are two colors on different sides and they just, the other side sticks out like a sore thumb. That's where I really get bugged. For Captain Britain, I will go, good 4.5 stars, because, I mean, he just looks very dynamic, and he looks very good, and different poses and different ways, and I mean, he's good, solid representation of the character. That head sculpt is really nice. Everything about him is just really cool. I like him. I like him a whole lot. So all you haters who say I hate Captain Britain, you're wrong. Kabish. Okay, so let's do up some comparisons here, and we have Captain America and Shang-Chi, Master of Kung Fu. We also have Spider-Man and Deadpool just for a little fun. And then just for fun, brought in his old Excalibur teammate, Nightcrawler. Of course, that's the Toy Biz Nightcrawler. I don't have the Hasbro Nightcrawler. But, you know, I think it's still pretty good. I mean, that Nightcrawler has held up for years. And honestly, I never felt the desire to pursue the Hasbro one yet. I probably should, but, you know, that's what happens sometimes, is, you know, you get caught up in other things and you don't go after things. Right now in the aftermarket, the Hasbro one is just ridiculous, so I'm not even going to try. All right, so that's my review of Captain Britain here on Infinite Realms. Don't forget to like and subscribe. Have a great day. We'll see you next time.